3:30 p.m. It has taken, and the video isn't that long, but it has taken the better part of a day to upload that video. We're finding that YouTube is censoring and they're interfering so as to cause whatever type of headache they're trying. And this is just my letting you know that we will not be deterred from giving you information. Please, this video, we would definitely advise you to pay attention to what's being said. You will find that for many of you, it will be of interest. There is another video that is being uploaded. The title is, You Have a Right to Complain. Ladies and gentlemen, in conjunction with the You Have a Right to Complain, and I definitely would suggest that all of you pay attention to the information in that video. This is, let's pull that back up so that you guys can see. Oh, I wasn't trying to do that. Let's put it back where it was. Okay. This is the Redfield versus Fisher case. The individual, like the corporation, cannot be taxed for the mere privilege of existing. Now, I'm sorry, I am playing The Space Between Us with Mr. Craig Armstrong in the background. But it says the individual, unlike the corporation, cannot be taxed for the mere privilege of existing. See, the individual person is what it's referring to, because corporations are individuals too. But here they want to let you know that they're separating individual from corporations by corporations or individuals. What happened is, we do know that artificial constructs are created all the time. When the court makes a post office an officer of the court, when it makes a peace officer an officer of the court, when it makes a sheriff deputy an officer of the court, when it makes an attorney an officer of the court is creating artificial entities, creating capacities. Now, they can do that because when they do that, the corporation is an artificial entity which owes its existence and chartered power to the state. But the individual, that's you and I, our right to live and our right to own property ourselves are natural rights for the enjoyment, i.e. natural individuals, for the enjoyment of which the exercise or excise tax cannot be imposed. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what we're doing now. This information will be placed on the website soon, but this is a complaint. This complaint is going to be given to each of you. Sorry, I don't like the fact that local is split up like that, so one second. Okay. This will be placed online for each of you to have access to soon. Do not email us. Do not ask us where is it. You will be given notice of where this particular document is for your benefit. This is to the United States and the government locally. My complaint on judicial misconduct and disability. Remember, they're all officers of the court. So I think, you know what? Let's do that. Let's change this to judicial and or officer misconduct. And I'll explain that in a moment. /OFFICER. And we're bringing misconduct complaint. We're not bringing a complaint against their conduct. We're bringing a misconduct complaint. So make sure that it says misconduct and not just conduct. So judicial and or officer misconduct and disability. So this is a complaint on that. A complaint of judicial misconduct and or judicial disability. Let's do this. You see, they're the ones who limit it to only judicial officers. Let's put misconduct or disability against the judge of the United States in and for the district of the United States, as well as other officers of the court. Ladies and gentlemen, by the way, your state judge is a U.S. judge because the judge sits in the district of whatever the state is, in the district of whatever the county is, in the district of wherever the city is. They sit in the district. That's why they are registered. So, because the judge is an officer of the court, because the police officers are officers of the court, that's what this section says. This presentment is properly titled as judges are said to be officers of the court, which means that a complaint is proper when brought against an officer of the institution, sheriffs, deputies, attorneys, and or police officers are officers of the court. You've heard them say that a police officer is an officer of the court. You've heard them say that the post office is an officer of the court. So there are a lot of officers of the court. Well, if these guys are officers of the court, as well as the clerk of the court, and we're going to take clerk and we're going to take court, sorry, we're going to take both of these and we're going to capitalize these two C's. The clerk of the court, which, see, as well as the clerk of the court, then we, uh-oh, sorry, we comma, which makes a complaint proper through the very same venue, exercising the same jurisdiction over these parties for which this presentment is deposited by a special deposit. Now, you guys have to go back and look at the old videos in 2012 regarding a special deposit. Okay, and then we're going to put the file on demand information here because that is absolutely necessary as well. Okay, and I think we will add text. And we're going to go. Okay, instead of putting file on demand, we're going to say filing is demanded. Why do we put it that way? Because we're not asking them for their permission. Okay? And I said if. I don't know how I put F when S is two buttons away from that. Let's put demanded and I can live with filing as demanded and mandatory. And we're going to put this in a different color so that it isn't red, because when it's done, it's gonna, we don't want it all to be the same. Okay, so we have the special deposit information, who may be complained about, and where to file a complaint. We're going to change this. Well, we'll do that. We're not going to put who may be complained about. We're going to put okay, who I am complaining about is what we're going to put. And we'll put LATION. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'll polish everything up later. Right now, this is the beginning. So basically, I said who I'm complaining about, violation of rights while acting under color of statute, a presumed law. Statutes are not law. So they have a statute where they do deprivation of rights while acting under color and authority of law. So statutes are not law. So when I bring this, I bring it not to highlight anything other than the fact that. Yeah, let's make it mostly one line. Be a whole lot easier that way. Yeah, because the number one is right about there with the rest of them. So, okay. So we bring that. Then it says, I believe that the judge purportedly acting under color of statute, rule, code, regulation, ordinance, law, has committed and or attempting to commit misconduct, or has a disability, and I choose to file a formal civil rights complaint about it with this office agency. Now, I will go back and correct things like this where the first letter is not capitalized. So, because this complaint may be against a judicial officer and or a judicial officer is involved, this complaint is being sent to the clerk's office of the United States Courts of Appeals for the Federal Circuit at Washington, D.C. Remember that. And this talks about the other locations where you're going to send a copy of the complaint if you should still choose to utilize it. Remember, this complaint is not because a judge did not agree with you. You don't ever want a judge to agree with you. You want a judge to do what is right. Follow the law, because that's the only way you can have fairness. But if you go over this, there are, I believe, 20-some different points that you affirm, that you document, that you state, that you let them know what you are believing, what you are aware of. This is the Redfield versus Fisher. Pay attention to what's being said here, because I think you will like it. I am further aware, based on other facts and conclusions of actual law, that an administrative officer, a legislative officer, nor a judicial officer has no authority so as to determine whether a member of the people, and I got to capitalize people, shame on me, is or is not an infant, a minor, juvenile, or otherwise after attainment of adulthood, i.e. the age of the majority, nor can these artificial agents acting in the capacity of entities, pay attention, nor can these artificial agents, yes, because they're creatures of the state, acting in the capacity of entities, or creatures of the state, maintaining artificial offices, creatures of the state, have the capacity and or the standing to determine whether one is alive in the flesh or otherwise. Ladies and gentlemen, these are artificial entities. The dead cannot determine the state of the living. They don't have the authority. They were never given the authority. It violates every aspect of the law for which they claim and purport to follow. For these officers are the individual natural person, unlike the corporation. No, we're going to say, oh, now, let's put, we can do that. Watch this. Okay, this is believed that the following is true. And then we put our comma and our space. The individual, natural person, unlike the corporation, cannot be taxed. We can add a capital to the end. For the mere privilege of existing. The corporation is an artificial entity which owes its existence and chartered power to the state. Ladies and gentlemen, these judges who sit on these benches receive their power as a result of some congressional act and or some constitutional act. That being the case, they only exist as a means of statute. They only exist as a means of law. Without the law, they don't exist. So they don't have the authority to sit up there and determine whether someone is living or dead, because only a living person can determine if another person is living. And that can only be done by a certified affidavit. So this is us letting you know, ladies and gentlemen, that we will be putting this document together. This document, once put together, will handle and say all of the things. Matter of fact, I got to make sure there's no more sentences under here. So let's see. Nope, didn't want to do that. And I make that mistake often. The way this works is like this. I have to double click on the inside to be able to bring this down, if it will let me. It's not letting me. And that doesn't make any sense. Oh, it won't let me go down any further. I just wanted to see if there were any more words after hereby, so I'll leave it. Yeah, it won't let me go down any further, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring it down just a little bit further. Alright, there we go. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, not going to keep this video going much longer because I want to get it up online for you so that those of you who are interested can have it. The only thing that you guys will have to look for is areas like this where it says that you are a citizen of the state of blah, 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 and no coin of art, term of art, or phrase, and or, yeah, we'll put or, some contrivance of man. See, you are not any contrivance of man. You're not an invention of man. You are a natural person. And as a natural person, you are a state citizen. Now, people say you don't want to be a citizen because a citizen is this, citizen is that. No, you elected to be a citizen when you came under the Constitution for your state. But you're only under the provision of citizen to the limited extent that you have allowed yourself to be governed by the Constitution for your state. Other than that, you maintain and retain those rights under Section 9 and 10. All right. Some people are going to look at these and say, these are arguments, this argument. We're not arguing nothing with the court. We're telling them what the facts are. Go ahead and take a look and see if anybody's arguing. See if anybody is saying this is what they think. Okay, we're not telling them anything other than who we are. And this will go to every single agency that is supposed to be addressing this, and you will find out who they are by looking through the document, because it lets you know the Attorney General's office is one, the Office of the United States Courts, Federal Circuit is another. And then you have the circuit for where the judge sits. Then you have the state level, because you will send it on the state level and the federal level. They're going to say, well, it needs to go here, it needs to go there. No, it went to the proper agency. So either you address it or you send it, because that's what it's demanding, that they send it to an actual lawful Article 3 judge so that you can have your proper hearing. Oh, and by the way, you're not trying to sue. Nope, you're seeking redress. And that's why you're documenting everything. Ladies and gentlemen, they give you a problem, then you file a claim against the insurance company. They're insured. Every single office is insured. Okay, you file your complaint against them. If they don't want to give you the information about who their insurance company is, then you file your complaint with the United States Treasury Department. Okay, we'll get that information to you soon. Just wanted to get this information to you. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to ask that you guys have a good day. Thank you for letting us take up your time. Have a good day, everyone.